Miss Warwick. I read that the 32nd anniversary of We Are the World is coming up next week, 32 years. Take me back to that magical time when 40 great artists, including yourself, are in one room for a great cause.
We were there to make sure that people in Africa, basically, were able to eat, feed them. So that's what We Are the World was really all about.
Women account for almost 20% of the estimated 45,000 new HIV infections in the United States.
And so many decades later, you are continuing your activism for women over 50 and HIV/AIDS awareness. Tell me about your latest PSA campaign.
Yeah, basically it's not only women over 50, it's women, period. Young girls who feel that they're infallible, like most of our babies do, have to understand that they're not. You have to also be cognizant of the virus. It still is running rampant. And it's very necessary to keep that message into people's eyes and ears. Education is very, very important, and educating them about this particular disease is still vitally important. I'm still in this fight. I haven't given the fight up. I likened it into a train ride. Told them I'm on at the first stop, and we're not getting off until this thing is cured.
You were one of the first artists to speak out and lend your voice and your face in the fight against AIDS. Take me back to That's What Friends Are For. That is a song that really changed people's mindsets around the world.
We had a wonderful, wonderful time because it was something we were singing about that meant something to all of us, friendship. As it turns out now, that it has been designated almost as the anthem for the AIDS problem. Which is fine with us. You know, we feel that if our talents and our vocal abilities have the wherewithal in which to encourage people to become compassionate enough to want to help rid us of this particular disease, then it was our pleasure to do it.
I love how your sound check is playing That's What Friends Are For now.
Yeah, right.
As we're talking about it, that's one of my favorite songs of yours.
Thank you.
It's Women's History Month. It's March, and you're still going strong at 76 on stage at Bethesda Blues and Jazz Supper Club. What is your message to our female viewers in their golden years?
Yeah, it's the same thing. You know, you have to, first of all, want it. If there is an alternative, nobody wants that. No, I enjoy what I do, and I intend to continue doing it until it becomes a job. I never wanted to work. So when it becomes a job, that's when you won't see me anymore. It's a pleasure to be in D.C. Of course, you know, I'm here so much, I feel like I belong to D.C. And I feel D.C. belongs to me.